this first lesson, I'm going to talk to you about writing the brief. Usually, in an agency environment, you'd receive briefs from your client. Now, if you're a startup and you wanted to start your own product or you wanted to start your own online shop, although it sounds like it's insignificant to write a brief to yourself, I would recommend for you to try and do that because it's an anchor for you to think about where you want to head in the future, or at least really it's just a conversation starter for yourself or a team. If you're in a small team environment, it's important to align what the vision is. Now, there are ways to go about this further, but I don't want to complicate the whole thing for you. Let's start with a very simple thing, and it's about writing the brief to yourself. Why do we need to do this? First of all, I'd like to outline that we need to have a specific challenge that your idea is intending to solve. Because at the end of the day, you need to know exactly what the deliverables are, whether they're practical and realistic. But we also need to keep this brief super, super simple for you just to understand. It's something that is foolproof. You need to be able to give it to someone else for them to read and clearly understand what you want to do. Now, here's an example. First, you start with a template of a challenge. What does a challenge look like? So it looks like this. You will start a sentence by writing down, create a what sort of product for which type of audience, which is your audience, to do what? So talk about the function in here, the function of your idea or your dream, whether it's an application or a website or some sort, but write down what the function is. And it's very important for this whole thing to be time bound as well, because as you know, when you start your own project without any time frame, you may fall by the wayside or your focus might get distracted into something else. I'm going to give you a quick example so it makes it feel real. Okay, so here's an example of a challenge: to create a user-friendly mobile app for health conscious cafe owners, those are the audience, to provide end-to-end food catering services, which is the function that I was talking about earlier, by the first half of the financial year. So therefore you have a time-bound challenge to work with. You know exactly, or maybe not exactly, but you're already starting to think about the actual product, a user-friendly mobile app, for example, for who? The health conscious cafe owners, which is your audience that you're targeting, or at least what you have in mind at the moment. Now remember, these things might evolve as you go through the process, but at least this is a simple starter for you and your team to start with. The other thing that's very important that comes with your brief is a list of deliverables, achievable deliverables that you think you need to deliver by the end of this process. This is for you to actually achieve your goal and to meet that challenge or that brief that you've set for yourself. I'm going to go through some examples here. So as I was thinking about the user-friendly mobile app that I had in mind, I'm thinking about an outcome where it's an iOS mobile app for the end users. And because there's Android as well as an operating system that I'd be targeting, I want to have Android mobile app as another outcome for the end users. I also want to have content management system for the vendors. So these are the cafe owners. Whereas previously when I spoke about the end users, it's the cafe vendors' end users, so their customers, to actually make this the booking and to use the services. But for the vendors itself, they need a content management system where they can upload menus or content, basically, for them to be able to sell to their users. And I also need another content management system, which is a separate thing to the one for the vendors, but it's for the admin. Let's say it's for myself as the startup, or my admin people in the office are the first intern that I've hired to help me out with the startup business. They can use this content management system to help me out with the business. So at a very top level, those are the main deliverables that I need to produce. So what does that mean to me as the business owner? It reminds me that there are more than just the mobile app itself. Even if we talk about mobile apps, there are two different kinds. There's an iOS one, there's an Android one. But hang on a second, how do I manage all of that? There are content management systems in the back end of all of this. It makes things a lot clearer for you that your dream is not as simple as just a mobile app, but there's a content management system behind all of this stuff. So you see where I'm heading. We need to go into something a lot more specific, but also realistic and relevant, as well as time-bound. With all of this being combined, you're in a good start to be able to achieve your dream, which is to launch your product. I know it sounds so simple, but I can't stress enough how important it is for you to write your own brief so that you have an anchor for yourself. And for the rest of the team that are involved, we use this process a lot, even in large organizations, just to start off or kick off a project so we know exactly what the expectations are and to align all of this between different stakeholders and different different people who are involved in the project. I'm gonna leave you with this Simon Sinek quote. If you've seen his book before or read his book before, it's called Start With Why, or at least that's one of the most popular ones. In his book, he talks about people don't buy what you do, but people buy why you do it. And what you do simply proves what you believe. It's actually a very important quote for you to kick off a project, because your reasons on why you do things is far greater, more important than you actually doing it. So this whole writing a brief thing is important for you to have, you know, a go-to once you're being diverted into all sorts of different places, because that things like that will happen. It's important for you to remember what your focus was. So what this means is you shouldn't hold back at all. If you want to start something, go and do it. Because at the end of the day, it's less about you overthinking the whole complexity. It's really about you taking the first step to get into something, and then you'll learn along the way. But with a systematic and methodical process like this, you'll be able to achieve things with lower risk and be able to measure, look back, iterate, and do all sorts of things like that as well. Okay, a couple of other tactical materials that you may like in this program is documenting user personas. Check that out. And also drawing the user journey map. This whole process will complement what we've just spoken about, which is writing the brief. I hope you enjoy this. Thank you for watching.